Hello and welcome to this episode of Class Captures. This is your host, Jasper Senior. In this episode, I'm going to talk about scientific notation in an introductory manner. So the big picture idea here is that when numbers have many zeros or many digits, mistakes can be made when transferring the numbers or when discussing the numbers of digits. And that's where we start to see something called scientific notation, which is like an abbreviation for these big numbers. So the first example I like to use is these two numbers, 100,000 versus 1 million. Only difference between them, one seemingly insignificant zero. And I say insignificant because zeros were always taught they mean nothing, right? Well, in this case, that one little zero equals 900,000. So I encourage you to think about this example in terms of like a banking example, right? Consider that difference, that little mistake of leaving off one zero would equal 900,000. And that sort of sets the stage for the importance of learning and using scientific notation and understanding that each digit is very important. All right, so scientific notation in our context may be used in terms of really big numbers, like the distance between stars. All right, so you know the sun is the closest star to planet Earth, 92 million miles about. There's a lot of zeros there, but when you start getting to other stars, they're, you know, hundreds or even thousands of times farther away. You get an incredibly long amount of digits there. And so we need some way to abbreviate that so that they can be transferred and discussed without making an error. Or you can have really small numbers, like I was just thinking of the diameter of a cell, or a very split second, or the size of a sediment particle, right? So a decimal with a lot of different a lot of places in it. That's where you might encounter using scientific notation as well. All right. So I know this expression at the top looks kind of intimidating, kind of like very mathematical. But when you just sort of take it apart and you look at the different parts, it's really very easy. M is the really big or really small number. N in scientific notation is always a number between 1.0 and 9.9. There's always a times 10, and then there's an exponent. All right, and that exponent is the number of places the decimals moved. If m, the original number, is very small as a decimal, then the exponent will be negative. All right, so let's take a number and let's put it into scientific notation. All right, so the first thing we need to do is we need to move the decimal point over to make the beginning of the expression between 1.0 and 9.9. How we do that is we go over like this, all right? And then we gotta count the number of places we moved that decimal point. In this example, we moved it three places, all right? So we come up with this 5,700 being in scientific notation as 5.7. Again, that's between 1.0 and 9.9. times 10 to the third, and the third comes from the fact that we moved the decimal three places. Let's take a number out of scientific notation, all right? So we have 1.5 times 10 to the fourth. And again, we're starting to see that sort of standard form of scientific notation. The first number between 1.0 and 9.9 always have a times 10 and then some exponent. All right, so we look at the exponent to see how many places we should move the decimal. All right, so we move it four places, right? So we've taken 1.5, we've moved the decimal over. And this is a good time to remind you that any whole number really has a decimal and zeros after it. All right, we just leave those off for convenience. Now, decimals again are the very small numbers, less than one. All right, and the way you handle those, you have an exponent, a negative exponent, and you basically just do the opposite of what you did for the positive exponents. All right, so it's just a clue to remember that it's a very small number, and you basically just move the decimal the opposite way. in earth science, we don't see the negative exponents that much, but I do want you to be aware of it. So thank you very much for watching this episode of Class Captures, and I hope you'll stay tuned for more episodes soon.